Jack, are we ready?
We are.
You are? Okay. This is the regular session, Board of Commissioners, October 2nd, 2017. I ask everybody to please put their cell phones on mute and will stand in the room. Unless we just got our tax bill. Okay, I'll now call this meeting to order. Would you please call the roll?
Mayor Yancey.
Here.
Commissioner Gayor.
Here.
Commissioner Latanzi.
Here. Would you please read the sunshine notes?
Notice of time and place of this meeting has been posted in the office of the municipal clerk, published by the Beach Grove Times and the Asbury Park Press on December 22nd, 2016, and filed with the municipal clerk.
Thank you. I'll ask for a motion to dispense with the reading of the minutes of the previous meeting and to approve the same as recorded in the minute book.
Second.
Commissioner Latanzi.
Yes.
Commissioner Gayor.
Yes.
Mayor Yancey.
Yes. We'll start the agenda portion of the meeting. Our first kind of business is we have a new police officer. We're going to swear her in. Justin, do you have somebody that you would like? Okay. See you after the day, are you ready? I, Jessica Burkhardt.
I, Jessica Burkhardt.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of New Jersey.
And the Constitution of the State of New Jersey.
That I will bear true faith.
That I will bear true faith.
And allegiance.
And allegiance.
To the same.
To the same.
And to the governments established in the United States.
And to the governments established in the United States.
And in this state.
And in this state.
Under the authority of the people.
Under the authority of the people.
And that I will faithfully.
And that I will faithfully.
Impartially and justly.
Impartially and justly.
Perform all the duties.
All the duties.
Of the office of police officer.
Of the office of police officer.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Thanks, sir.
Chief, would you like to?
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mayor. Thank you, Council. Officer Burkhardt, I'll be brief. Town has other business. Officer's been with us for 2.5 years, exceptional. Brings to the table what this department is about. It's community service, community involvement. She's an EMT, exceptionally trained, dedicated, and she will be a true asset and represent what this department is about and what it has been about. So I welcome you aboard, and hopefully you have 25 years go as quick as mine, which is today. I'm 25 years, I can retire today. You'll enjoy it, it goes by fast, especially working for this town. Thank you.
Thank you. Congratulations and the greatest of pictures. Proclamations.
Our first proclamation is National Friends of the Library Meeting, which is October 15th, 2017, and I believe you have a presentation.
Sure. Please come up.
My name is Judy Backman. I'm president of the Friends of the Island Library, and I'd like to thank you all. As most of you know, the Friends are made up of a group of individuals who support the library. If it weren't for the Friends, we wouldn't have an island branch of the Island Library. But of course, that was before our time. But we hope that we are upholding the tradition of advocating for the library and supporting it. Many of you have come to our programs. Bernadette is head of our program committee and also my vice president. We have a very active committee that presents historical and entertaining and just the kind of program and events. We just came back from Brain Games, which some of you are part of, which also gets the community together. Friends in the past were responsible for purchasing the first branch of the island branch of the Ocean County Library. And most recently, the Friends have purchased the wonderful electronic sign that really helps in getting out the word. Other purchases was the circulation desk, the dolphins in the clear story, and even the room darkening shades so that movies can be watched more. The Friends also are responsible for two scholarships a year, one to a graduating senior who has worked at the library and one to someone who is pursuing a library degree. So we are always looking for Friends, and we have invitations here on Sunday the 15th. The library is open, which we never are open on Sunday, but on the 15th we open up the branch for some refreshments and entertainment. And it's a lovely day for all. Thank you. And also with me is Laura Arluna, who is our membership chairman. So we're always looking for new members and people to work with us and help make the library even better. Thank you.
Thank you, and good job. I'd like to acknowledge Linda Feaster here. Share with us how long?
With the branch, Linda and half years.
Linda does a great job at the library, and we thank her.
Thank you.
And thank you for the Friends of the Library. You do a wonderful job.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right, Liz?
Next we have, we're going to recognize Women's Health Month, October 2017, that encourages all women of Ocean County to participate in many programs and services available throughout the county, which will contribute to their quality of life. We're also recognizing Pregnancy and Infant Loss Awareness Month, October 2017. This supports women and families that have faced miscarriage, stillbirth, or the loss of an infant.
All right, thank you. We'll now move on to ordinances and public hearings.
Second reading ordinance 17-31C, an ordinance amending an ordinance entitled Code of the Township of Long Beach, County of Ocean, State of New Jersey, 1997, as the same pertains to the creation of a new Chapter 114, regulating and limiting the use of plastic bags by businesses in the township. Cast on first reading at a regular meeting held on July 3rd, 2017, and advertised in the Beach Haven Times issue of July 6th, 2017, and August 10th, 2017.
Thank you. I'm going to open this to the public for anybody here that wants to comment on this, but we had a meeting with the ACME today, and we're going to postpone the ratification of this for 1 month. They want to come in and give us some more input. But however, I'm opening this up for comments for people that are here today. Any comments?
Deal of taking all the bags.
Thank you.
Free. You have a 100. generate a lot of plastic. Everything's wrapped in plastic. We still need containers to, and I haven't found them on the island, maybe, but I don't get a lot of bags because I'm used to not using them.
What town do you come from?
Well, I moved from Jersey to Maine 5 years ago. And my towns are gone. And, but the reality is people use them for things. They do use them to line their trash bag and cans. They use them for other things. But you're right, people take too many. And even if you get rid of them, you still need containers to collect them.
Thank you very much. Any other comments?
I'm sure you are aware of Michael Capiero, 42 Antioch Road in Township. Yes, support the ban on plastic bags. And even more, I know we have a blue one release ban, but I don't know if we have a blue one versus ban. And I know other towns have done a lot of stuff with plastic straws. I don't want to divert from this toward the ban on plastic bags.
Thank you. One step at a time.
Yeah.
Balloons are big though.
Judy Bowden again, 9101 Beach Ave in the township. I'm not only a library advocate, but an environmental advocate. I walk the beach every day. I'm a beachcomber. And more times than not, we pick up more trash, which is plastic, than treasure. If you go to the plastic sites, you will see how much damage it does. I applaud the ban on balloon releases. I'm hoping the balloon, just like realtor balloons and open house balloons and outside use of balloons can be more strictly enforced, because they're inevitably going to wind up on our beaches and our oceans and killing wildlife. So also a big supporter of eliminating plastic whenever we can. Thanks so much.
We are, we're just waiting on some final details with ACME, but, you know, we will be passing a bill. We just want to get their input in writing and get that. Yes, Donna?
My name's Diane McKay. I'm from the Hot Ladies. I am in support of banning plastic bags. I thought I knew that plastic was bad until I saw this movie, Plastic Ocean, and it enlightened me, made me so aware of exactly how bad it is. And I think, you know, we're gonna have plastic, but people don't know how to dispose of it properly. When it's not disposed of properly, if you saw in this movie what it does, it's like, I immediately took all of my bags that when I go to the grocery store, I always forget them, they're in my trunk, they're now on my front seat. I don't want any more bags, because it was horrifying what you see happens in the movie.
Thank you very much. Any other comments?
No.
Yes, sir.
My name's Pam Sturzo, and I also live in Love Ladies. And I also saw that movie, The Plastic Ocean, which I recommend to everybody. And I've been told it's on Netflix. If you get Netflix, you can watch it on Netflix. It's just appalling. I have a son who lives in San Francisco, a daughter who lives in Montgomery County, Maryland. Both places, well, in San Francisco, there are no plastic bags. In Montgomery County, Maryland, you pay. I think it's 5 cents for a plastic bag. So it's become a way of life. San Francisco banned them 10 years ago. And all you have to do is, you know, have bags in your car. I know they recycle them over at ShopRite, which I try and do it when I get them. I mean, even when you get takeout food, you get a styrofoam box, which they put in a plastic bag, so it's like double whammy. So here's what I keep in my bag. Here's a little bag. It just folds up. And this is what I take with me. Simple. Everybody can do it. So I hope it goes through.
Thank you very much. Okay. Hearing everybody's finished, I would like to hear a motion on postponing or tabling it for a month, and we'll bring it up again next month.
Second.
Commissioner Lattanzi?
Yes.
Commissioner Bayard?
Yes.
Mayor Mancini?
Yes.
Second reading ordinance 17-34C, ordinance amending an ordinance entitled Code of the Township of Long Beach, County of Ocean, State of New Jersey, 1997, as the same pertains to the amendment of and revisions to Chapter 189, regulating traffic and parking in the township. Passed on first reading and regular meeting held on September 11, 2017, and advertised in the Beach Haven Times issue of September 14, 2017.
Thank you. I'll open this to the public for comment.
Could you say what it is, because...
Anything you want to expound on?
It is formalizing the parking regulations on 68th Street.
Which is this street right here. Any comments? Hearing and seeing none, we'll close the public hearing. I'll ask for a motion approving.
Second.
Commissioner Lutansky.
Yes.
Commissioner Bayard.
Yes.
Mayor Mancini.
Yes.
Second reading ordinance 17-35, bond ordinance authorizing acquisition and installation of water meters in the Township of Long Beach, County of Ocean, New Jersey, appropriating the sum of $4 million therefore, authorizing issuance of general obligation bonds or bond anticipation notes of the Township of Long Beach, County of Ocean, New Jersey, in the aggregate principal amount of up to $4 million, making certain determinations and covenants, and authorizing certain related actions in connection with the foregoing. Passed on first reading and regular meeting held on September 11, 2017, and advertised in the Beach Haven Times issue of September 14, 2017.
Thank you. I'll open this to the public for comment.
I do have a question.
Yes.
Are there amounts of water that are, like, do you use this amount versus this amount versus this amount?
It hasn't been determined yet. They're just getting it ready to go on to put the fees have not been established yet.
But that's why we're getting meters.
Yes, everybody's gonna be metered. Some people who, you know, very frugal. I also same amount as somebody who has 2 acres in landscaping, so yes, this will all be, yeah. So you'll be billed for what you use, so that's what we're doing. Any other comments? Hearing and seeing none? Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, Phil?
Who's gonna pay for installing these meters?
You are.
Yes.
This is mine, all of them.
You can pay for more if you want.
Yeah. One kind of street, yeah.
We're gonna be billed on our water bill?
Yes.
How's it gonna work?
Yeah, it's gonna be billed. There's gonna be a one-time payment, a two-time payment, or over 2 years, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, over 2 years.
2 years, wouldn't it?
Yeah, we're gonna start in Love Ladies first. On the south end, we have our own water plants. On the north end, we buy water from Surf City, Harvey Cedars, and Harvey Lake. And they're starting to escalate out, plus that's where most of the larger landscaped properties are, so we wanna get that in first.
Will it work around the landscaping, or will they go where they have to go regardless?
Well, we're recommending the in-house water meter, located in the house, right above where the water comes in, so we don't have to dig anything up, because we don't wanna get involved in fixing anybody's papers or whatever, because you know, the minute we touch them, they're gonna sink, they're gonna hold water. So if somebody wants to put a pit out front, that's up to them. But we're recommending the in-the-house water meter.
A homeowner's gonna have that option?
Yes. And that's what we're recommending.
Thank you.
Are there sensors?
How are they?
That's the same question.
Come on up, tell us who you are. We all know who Bill is. Yeah, this is all being mandated by the DEP, by the way. We've been dragging our feet for a lot of years here. But, you know, we have to do it now because we're requiring us to drill test wells and everything else to see if there's any seawater intrusion coming in, so that's why we finally have to pull the trigger on this. Yes, sir?
My name's Dave Brown, I'm here in Prairie Beach. How will they be read? They're in the house electronically?
Yeah, they're all Wi-Fi. They'll be read remotely. They'll come right into the office here.
Oh.
That's yeah, so it'll, no, we won't be banging on your doors. Any other question? Comments, hearing and seeing none, we'll close the public hearing. I'll ask for a motion to adopt ordinance 17-36C on second reading.
So moved.
Second.
Commissioner Lutansky.
Yes.
Commissioner Bayard.
Yes.
Mayor Mancini.
Yes.
Second reading ordinance 17-36C.
Let me correct. That motion was for 17-35. That we just had the motion in the board. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Second reading ordinance 17-36C. An ordinance amending an ordinance entitled Code of the Township of Long Beach County, Motion State of New Jersey, 1997, as the same in Chapter 57 pertains to the regulation of drone technology and unmanned aircraft for the Township of Long Beach. Passed on first reading and regular meeting held on September 11th, 2017, and advertised in the Beach Haven Times issue of September 14th, 2017.
Thank you. We'll open this to the public for any comment. Yes.
Good evening. David Fallon, Nyahawken, New Jersey. Can you just explain the proposed change?
Yeah, we're narrowing it down, making it more specific. So it's 100 foot from beach covers, the people on the beach, 20 feet from property. And you still have to fill out the application. So we'll have more detail, and we have a copy of the ordinance.
They'll be on the bulletin board. If you'd like to stay after the meeting, I can make you a copy.
The reason I'm asking is the distinction between commercial operation and personal or hobbyist.
This is all drone operation. All drone. Yeah, we're restricting it there. They have too many flying over kids on the beach.
Understood that. I was going to talk on a general topic, but since this is related to the ordinance, can I speak now?
Yeah, that's fine.
I had written to the borough attorney, Mr. McGee, on August 11th, and did not get a response to that. I sent a follow-up on September 1st, to which I got silence. I then wrote to Mr. Zabarsky, as the municipal prosecutor, asking for interpretation on the section of the ordinance relating to commercial operation. And again, I have not yet gotten a response.
What's your question?
The question is whether or not the ordinance prohibiting operation applies to commercial use as regulated by Part 107 of the FAA regulations.
Yes, you have to register. You have to come in and register on your shoot. Just give us a call after that as to where you're doing your drone flight.
Understood. I'm not sure if you're aware or not. The federal regulation.
I'm already aware of the federal regulation.
Okay.
So if you want to litigate it, we'd be happy to do that.
No, I'm not trying to be.
Well, you're asking me a question, and I just answered you.
I'm trying to get clarification, because before we do an operation, we'd like to know.
Just come in and talk to Lynn here, who does, Linda, who does all the submissions and the applications and process. And we have people in the office that, when you want to do a fly or a shoot, call them up, tell them where you're going to be, so we don't have somebody calling in the police on you. So we have that. It's all very simple.
Very simple. Is there any reason why I couldn't get that? I had to come here, I just.
I don't know, Ted McGee is the most cooperative and responsive guy in the world.
Yeah.
And number one, I don't know why you would be calling him instead of me or the administrator.
Well, it was an interpretation of an ordinance.
Well, the right ones are right to ordinance.
I'm sorry?
We write the ordinance.
Okay, well.
Okay.
All right.
All right, have a nice day.
Thank you.
Any other comments? Seeing and hearing none, close the public hearing. I'll ask for a motion to approve ordinance 17-13. 37C.
So moved.
Second.
Commissioner Latanzi?
Yes.
Commissioner Vayour?
Yes.
Mayor Mancini?
Yes. The problem we have with these drones is we have these perverts that take their drones down on the beach over young ladies. And they get their jollies on, and I will not tolerate it. So I want everybody to understand. No more questions. I want everybody to understand that that's why we're doing it. And then when they get out of range of radio control, these drones are big, they fall from the sky. And all we need is one of them to hit somebody and then kill somebody. So we want to know who's out there, when and why. So that's what we're doing. We don't even know. This is a family resort, and we don't go in for this kind of action. Go ahead, I'm sorry.
Okay. First reading ordinance 17-37C, the ordinance amending an ordinance entitled Code of Township of Long Beach, County of Ocean, State of New Jersey, 1997, is hereby amended by the adoption of a new chapter, Chapter 128, adopting certain regulations relating to outdoor lighting in the Township of Long Beach.
Thank you. I'll ask for a motion to approve ordinance 17-37C on first reading.
Second.
Commissioner Latanzi?
Yes.
Commissioner Vehill?
Yes.
Mayor Mancini?
Yes.
First reading ordinance 17-38C, an ordinance amending an ordinance entitled Code of the Township of Long Beach, County of Ocean, State of New Jersey, 1997, is hereby amended by the adoption of a new chapter, Chapter 106, adopting certain regulations relating to invasive plants in the Township of Long Beach.
Thank you. I'll ask for a motion to approve ordinance 17-38C on first reading.
Second.
Commissioner Latanzi?
Yes.
Commissioner Vehill?
Yes.
Mayor Mancini?
Yes. We'll move on to adoptions and approvals.
Resolution 17-1002.01, support state legislature to extend the 2% cap on police and fire arbitration contract awards. Resolution 17-1002.02, support the Mid-Atlantic Regional Ocean Plan. Resolution 17-1002.03, approve various water sewer changes. Resolution 17-1002.04, approve various personnel matters.
Thank you. I'll ask for a motion to approve items 7 through 10.
Second.
Commissioner Latanzi?
Yes.
Commissioner Vehill?
Yes.
Mayor Mancini?
Yes. Move on to purchases, contracts, and awards.
Resolution 17-1002.05, reaffirming the continuation of a shared service. This is for trash pickup in Harvey Cedars on William Street, which is shared between Long Beach Township and Harvey Cedars.
Thank you. I'll ask for a motion to approve item 11.
So moved. Second.
Commissioner Latanzi?
Yes.
Commissioner Vehill?
Yes.
Mayor Mancini?
Yes. I'll move on to financial approvals.
Resolution 17-1002.06, approve bills and payroll. Bills in the amount of $3,915,024.14. Payroll in the amount of $1,095,808.01.
Thank you. I'll ask for a motion to approve item 12.
So moved. Second.
Commissioner Latanzi?
Yes.
Commissioner Vehill?
Yes.
Mayor Mancini?
Yes. Well, now, Kyle, the administrator's report.
Last weekend for shuttles, this weekend, we have the Kite Festival. I'm sure Bill will talk about that in a little bit more. We got delayed on beach replenishment again. October 11th is the opening for Holgate. This is the 8th Amendment.
Thank you. I will now enter into the commissioner's reports. Commissioner Latanzi?
Yes, so, what's there? Close to final numbers for the shuttle, it'll be 110,000. And our Gator program, close to 9,500 riders, donations about 32,000. So just for the shuttle, that's about 30 cents a rider. So we have a campaign out, to save the shuttle, and we're kind of trying to lay out the rationale for doing this. I mean, like I've talked on many occasions here financially, this has gotten too large for us to fund just through advertisements and donations, and we're asking for a resolution that's going to be on the ballot in November to at least give us the opportunity to charge a fee. Now, we haven't set up any structures, and, again, we have some ideas around children and senior citizens, and obviously probably have an escalating cost for later tonight. But again, hopefully, we don't have to go that route, but if the numbers keep expanding, we can't afford to continue to provide a service for free, probably. So at least this is just giving us the option to do that. And the reason we need it is obviously because it's a town-run shuttle. We need resolutions that we need to support. These things get approved from the public to go forward. So we're asking everybody to support that.
Thank you, Commissioner. Commissioner Barrett?
The only thing I have is bluegrass will be available at the Public Works Yard starting October 7th. The yard will be open Saturday and Sunday, October 7th and the 8th, from 7 a.m. to 12 p.m. And the following weekend, October 14th and 15th, from 7 a.m. to 12 p.m. Grass will be available during the week, 8 a.m. to 2 p.m., except on Monday, which is Columbus Day, and there it will be open 7 a.m. to 12 p.m. And dogs are allowed on the beach as of October 1st.
Thank you, Ralph. Before I start, I would like to just take 15 seconds of silence for those poor people in Las Vegas. Horrible.
And Puerto Rico.
next meeting of the Land Use Board will be held on Wednesday, October 11th at 7 p.m. in the upstairs multipurpose room. Second reading of public hearings, hearing for ordinances 17-37C, 38C will be, take place at the public meeting held on November 6th, 2017 at 4 p.m.
Mayor Mancini, I'd just like to add that we're also going to have the plastic bag ordinance.
Okay, yeah, good. Thank you, Linda. That will all be good. Once again, I want to ask everybody to please support not only the bus referendum, because it should be a use fee. If you don't use the buses, you shouldn't be paying for them. So this will be a use fee. You want to ride the buses. We're nonprofit, obviously. We just want to make sure that we have enough equipment. Nothing worse than having somebody standing on the corner for 20 minutes and then the bus pulls up. There's too many people on the bus and you can't get on. So that's really creating a few problems. And yeah, Commissioner Latanzie was too successful in this endeavor. So we want to thank him for doing that. But we definitely need some funding on that. The second thing is we have the 1 cent open space referendum coming up. As you can see, in Long Beach Township, we don't have enough open space. And 1 penny for each person here, the average person would pay $85. It would be $850,000 that we would raise per year, which would be matched by a county. So that's $1.7 million. So as property comes on the market in a congested area, we'd like to buy that property so there's more open space around you. So that's what we're trying to do. We tried to do this 7 years ago. It was turned down. And I think the time is right that we really, you know, it's not that much. We really need your support on that. So that's all I have to say. I'll now open the public hearing. Anybody have anything to say, please come up, tell us who you are. And where do you live?
Janet Drew. I live on 30th Street. I used to live across the street from me. Everything I have is came about was related to the environment. So plastic bags was already on my list. I read in there was an insert about, and it's on your calendar, what we accept as far as recycling, and but the paper insert also talked about how our numbers and percentages and weights are so terrible compared to other places. And I said, other places, we can recycle cereal boxes and what else, milk cartons. There's all these things that I've always been able to recycle that you can't hear. So I'm wondering if our numbers are abysmal because of all the things we're not supposed to recycle.
Let me just give a rough water.
Yeah, the county is the one that that sort of drives what we're going to recycle and what we're not going to recycle, because everything goes up to their Southern Recycling Center up there. For some reason, their equipment can't handle they don't want to. Well, let's put it this way: they probably can't get any money for cereal boxes and things like that. Because the reason you recycle is to make a little money, and not only save the environment, but to make a little money. And for some reason, they don't include cereal boxes. But the county is the one that really drives the recycling program.
Okay, that was that. And then you talked about open space. So the other thing that was on my list was pavers, semi-permeable pavers. If this is part of what the building ordinance requires now, I don't know. I'm asking the question. Water barrels. I mean, you know, if everybody could collect 60 gallons of water every time it poured a lot, it would make a difference. I mean, I admit it's a drop in the bucket, but you know, it seems like it would help. So
well, we do have water barrels. In the township, in our property.
We don't have any requirement about using them.
No, we don't have a requirement. We do have a requirement on a percentage of coverage for papers. We do have it. Yes.
Okay.
And we also run several programs for people that want to have barrels.
They're wonderful.
Our recycling coordinator runs that, and she has various helpers with her, and, you know, they'll take barrels and they'll paint it and things like that. So we do have a program that people want to get involved with the barrels. We do have programs that do that.
Seems like it would be great to partner with the schools, you know. First of all, when the kids could get involved in painting barrels, the parents would hear about the barrels. I'm done.
Thank you.
Hi, Joni Bickham, Bayview Park Director. I just want to remind people, I know Bill's going to talk a little bit more about this, about the Kite Festival. I've been out advertising all weekend. And over at Bayview Park, well, I've been working with the LBI Arts Council as well as the Chamber. We're going to have a Kite Festival Bazaar as well as a High Flyers Art Market over there and family kite making. And with the oyster kites are going to be flown over there too. I'm working with Angela to do that as well. So Sunny Ray's Kitchen will be there, and I also have entertainment both Saturday and Sunday. So I hope that you all come out, bring your family, enjoy yourselves over there as well as throughout the island. We have a lot of different great events going on. So we're growing every year, and we look forward to a great event this weekend. Thank you.
Thank you,
Joni.
Good job.
Next year,
Hi, Mayor Bill Hessen, Washington Avenue, Beach Haven, and Holgate. I want to thank Kyle for reminding me about the Kite Fest. Joni reminded me. I just want to tell you, the Kite Fest starts on Friday night. We have an indoor fly at the Shipbottom School. It's the most amazing thing. If people want to come out and see kite flyers, fly kites inside with no wind. It's, to me, just very amazing. And then Saturday and Sunday and Monday is at Shipbottom along the beaches. And we, of course, at our park, have Bayview Park and the township, we have kids kite making. We have just so many things going on, as Joni was alluding to, that Saturday and Sunday. And then Sunday night is back up at Barnegat Light. We do the night fly. It starts about 7 o'clock up in Angelo's territory. He has that nice everything up there for us to have a night fly. So we wanted to tell everybody, please come out and see a great event. It's just a phenomenal event. It's our third year, by the way. Next topic, I want to thank Linda Feaster and the library. They do a great job up there. We always have our meetings there, and they just do a very nice job. I want to thank them. Moving right along, the buses. You know, I've been in a number of meetings listening to people about the buses, and I would say the vast majority of our township voters and residents are for them. I hear a lot of compliments from some of our seniors saying they take those buses to the doctor or maybe to Acme or go shopping and get some food. And I hear a lot of compliments from parents. They tell me how it saves many trips. I'll give you an example there. Let's say somebody was taking their kid to somewhere to do something. So they have to take their kid there. Then they have to come back home. That's two trips. And they have to go back and pick the kid again up, take them somewhere else. That's four trips. So in a day, they could be making 4 to 6 trips in their car for one kid. So it's true, we have a lot of kids on the buses, but I think it saves tremendous amounts of traffic on the island. And you're talking about an open space tax, which I support, by the way, but there's just not enough parking anywhere. I'm sure we all know we need a lot more parking. One way to add to the parking is to encourage these people to ride the buses and to have the buses that you, the commissioners, and the general community, of course, wants to get bigger buses. So we do support that. So I'm just trying to let everybody understand how critical it is to the whole island. Next thing, if you don't mind, I can talk about the schools for a second. I was very elated that we voted down an $18.5 million bond proposal. But I think my concern is, as the board president said, that we're just kicking the can down the road, and he was very arrogant in saying that they're going to go out to that vote again. Now, I want you to understand, they didn't get voted down just by a couple points. They got voted down 67% to 33%. That's 2-1. And if they can't take notice that the township taxpayers and the island taxpayers aren't for that, then they better relook at the numbers, because that's pretty overwhelming, 2-1. So I did want to point that out and think that maybe they may want to rethink their position. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Bill. Any other comments? Yes, sir.
Good
Bernadette Callanan, 101 East 27th Street, Beach Haven Gardens. I'm pretty sure that the township is responsible for the Veterans Park, the new Veterans Park.
Yes.
And I just want to thank you. What a difference it made. And, you know, when you go over to get the donuts on a sunny morning, it's so nice to see that lovely park.
Thank you.
And that's part of the open space idea.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
That's the first of many, hopefully.
Thank you very much.
Enjoy.
Okay. Seeing and hearing and no other comments, I'll ask for motion to close the public session.
So moved. Second.
Commissioner Latanzi?
Yes.
Commissioner Vaillant?
Yes.
Mayor Mancini?
Yes. Meeting adjourned. Thank you all for your comments and thank you for coming.